Hello people, welcome back to Dutch Modeling. Today we're going to do another inbox review. And this time it's going to be a whole different kind of beast. This is going to be the Lockheed Martin, the F-35A Lightning II fighter for the Royal Netherlands Air Force. This one is in the special colors for the 323 Squadron up in Leeuwarden. It's a different imagination of Diana, Huntress, goddess of the Huntress, And this is actually, as you can see here, the logo. And this is the real bird. So it's close. It's for their 70 year anniversary. And I think there are more pictures of that one. But and this one is a bigger one. Give me a second though. Of course, I cannot really get it now. Nope. Yeah, well, it is quite close to the real thing. And this is a special first. This is the first Dutch squadron to receive the F-35, and it combines with the 70 year anniversary. So, this kit is by Meng, sponsored by me to Dominos.be. As you can see in my intro, and it's going to be interesting, to say the least. It's one for the 8th scale. Kit is LS-011. See it down there. It's production for users above age 14, so it's not for kids. So YouTube, no kids here. There's a on the side a overview of the colors you need, and these are in AK. Then you got the Lockheed Martin logo with the side view, the roundel for the Royal Netherlands Air Force, and again the side view of F-001. Two links to Facebook, and don't know what that is, and don't know what that is either. Again, here's the box art on the side with again the number and the name, and here it's all over again. As you can see, it's a 2019 kit. So let's open the box, which is quite big. And I'm not used to planes, and especially not used to modern jets. So the booklet, and this is, I think, quite big. There's not a massive amount of plastic in here, I would say. Pick it up and put it aside. And I can put the box aside, and as usual, we start with the instructions. No, I do not have Corona. And there is something about, I think, the F-40A, this one in Japanese, Chinese, English, again, Japanese or Chinese. And Russian. Then read before assembly, plastic model kit, tools you need, and then they start. They start with the ejection seat. That's the easy part because they tell me what they're doing, so I know what I'm telling you. And this is the seat belt. This is W1. What does that mean? See, we're starting, I already have no clue what I'm doing. I'm guessing this is photo edge or tackle, one of the two, but by the looks of it, it's bent, so this will be photo edge. Then you got cockpit assembly. The seat, oh, this is a strange view. The seat goes in, this is kept on its side for some reason. Pedals, this is the instrument panel. It goes all in, again, on its side for some reason. Joysticks, flight controls, and the cover. Then you got the nose gear assembly. Again, the point, the wheel, arms, the thingies, hydraulic pumps, I'm guessing there. Light, most likely. And it goes into the nose gear. And do not install this part if the nose gear is in a retracted position. So if you've got wheels up, don't build this. This is the port side main landing gear bay assembly. So, well, again, the main stick and some parts. Here's the wheel, now my son's coming in. And this will be part of the landing gear bay. 1 second. Then they do bombs. Okay. GBU 53 small diameter small bombs and pylon assembly. Oh, that's very simple. This step doesn't apply if the weapons are built and the bay is closed. Yeah, if the weapons bay is built closed. Then you got the AIM-120, a medium range air-to-air missile. And again, this step does not apply if the weapons base are built closed. So this thing has only inside base. There are no pylons on the outside because it's a stealth fighter. I knew that. This is the starboard weapon bay assembly. Yeah, I'm just gonna install this if the weapon bays are built open. Okay, so actually all this you do not need to do if you're closed up. Using these two parts and or these three parts are part of the fuselage. Guessing, I'm not even not sure that. But and then the pylons with the bumps go in. And this is the other side. So exactly the same. Don't need to do this if you don't open them. There's no need. The inlet duct assembly. So this will be resembling a turbine, I guess. Turbine blades at least. Or just the to close it up. Let me see where that goes. But this is the rear part. Yeah, this will have some turbine blades modeled onto them, most likely G7. I'm gonna check it in a little bit. Then you got attaching the weapon base. Go up there, one up there. Nose bay gear goes in here, and you got the. These are the is the engine, or well, at least the afterburner part. You don't see the rest. And here's the attaching the inlet ducts. You can see here it's just in the middle. And the starboard and port side main landing gear base. And they have to check. This is the underside of the plane. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I do not build planes a lot. This is the underside, not the upside. And they got them with the wheels down, so. Attaching the cockpit, it goes in the upper side. I knew that. Drill some holes here. Then you got the attaching the fuselages. Going vertical, so you got a horizontal line. And what I do know from most planes is if you do it the other side, so from side to side, you got a massive seam line on the top, which you do not have now. And that's always a good thing. And I can see here to my right, it's lying there. There's a lot of locator pins, so it will be easier to put in the right spot. This is the... this one doesn't have the turbine, so there won't be that. I don't know what's that for then. Maybe the refueling cap. No, refueling cap should be there. That goes there. No clue what that is. Sorry. Pylon assembly. So it has pylons. This step does not allow if it's now on the wing store. So if you do not want to use a pilot on the wings, skip this. Skip this. And skip this. So. It probably will be the most interesting build to see if it actually has pylons under the wings. Otherwise you just skipped three steps. And then you got them touching the main wings. Elevator at 10%, elevator at 0%. And these are the other sides, okay? And the elevators are the flaps on the front. So they're probably on the back then. Oh no, these are here, on the back. You can see here, so you choose which one you want. The wings just go in. Or on, not even in, but on, as you can see. Wow, I'm bad at this. And this is... I have no clue. Empennage assembly. This has something to do with flight characteristics. Yeah, these are the vertical and horizontal flight stabilizers. And they call it empennage. Never knew that. They're building this up and putting them in here. And then they turn it around again and they go belly accessories. And belly door assembly. So you got them open or closed. What I'm guessing. Nope. Boom. This step does not apply if weapon bays are built open or landing gears are in retracted position. But if your weapon gears are open, you should have doors and landing gear and the doors and the weapon bay doors and everything also open, I think. Might be wrong. Maybe it's a different step. Belly door assembly part 2. Again, this is if everything is closed. Landing gear bay, oh, you're gonna build up the landing bay and weapon doors now. So that's why they didn't put it in. These are landing nose gear, port side weapon, port side, sorry, port side landing gear bay door, nose gear again. Okay. Starboard landing gear bay door and starboard landing. Yeah, I'm losing the plot here, sorry guys. And the weapon bay doors, and then everything goes in set. But this step does not apply when you build everything closed, of course. And more doors, and here are the AIM-120s, how you should attach them, if you want them. And one of the final things is attaching the canopy, here. Again, open or closed, whatever you want. And this is an overview of a possible layout of weapons here. And then here's the sprue map. W are decals, like I thought. And here's the intake or PE parts. These are decals. And just a sprue map. And the color references are for Meng AK or Acrision. Never heard of those. And that must be the baddest review of the instructions I've ever done. Sorry guys, I just really do not know what I'm doing with a modern airplane. And this is one for the 323 squadron, must be. And it's all in black, blackish. As you can see, well, there's only one color. There's the tail art. And this is the only squadron yet to have this plane. So but I've seen it, and this color does not come close to the truth. It's way more grayish. And here you got the bombs and missiles with a lot of decals. And also this is a decal layout. And here's also a decal layout with it. And that means a whole lot of deckling. To the plastic. These are sealed with Ultimia style. Where did I leave my light? I'd rather not hit the plastic, right? Or the mail. Oh, I forgot the decals, I will do them at the end. So, a two-part fuselage. And it's, as you can see, quite big. I'm gonna have to hypnotize you for a little bit. So this is 25. So it's from there to here. That's almost 30 centimeters. So you will have, well, a little bit extra here, and then it will all in all be 30 centimeters long. So be right back. So these are two fuselage halves, upper and lower, and a lot of binding pieces still. Nice ring, nose ring. Yeah, it has a nose ring. Well, it's a lot of raised detail. To give it a different color. I don't know how much raised, how much these actually are raised on the real plane. You would think not at all, because it gives a lot of reflective edges. And being a stealth aircraft, reflective edges aren't that good. Oh, seems a whole lot of riveting in here. And sharp edges. I'll go over there, as you can see. Just a little section. And then there's the serrated edge. The engine. And there's not... Yeah, there's the name. But further there's no internal detail. I wonder if there's here this bump. There. And there's not on the other side. I wonder if this is supposed to be there. I noticed it because there's this indentation here, which isn't here. So let's see if I can. I'm just gonna check if I can see something in the instruction. Oh, it's, as you can see on the color callouts, there it is and there it isn't. So it is actually asymmetric. And I could say I'm gonna try and fit it, but then you got the nose. No, you don't have the nose ring anymore. Well, I have to clean it up at the nose, of course, but all in all, not too bad. Nice fit on the edges, and there's some cleanup to do, of course, but I mean, that's a sharp, it's a nice closure. Okay, cool. And let you remind me, I have no clue what I'm looking at, so for the most part. Let's start with the rest of the sprues. Where's my knife? There's my knife. These are panels. They're two of the same sprue. Some small detail on there. Give you a close-up of one of them. There's not really a lot to see, but still. You can see some detail on there. And you got two of them. So that was quick. Next up, bombs. And the bombs. Again, two of the same. Yeah, these seem to be bombs. Again, a lot of surface detail, as you can see. I think they're all the same. Maybe there are slight differences, but they look all the same. So. Next, again, this is the AIM, the rocket, that one I actually, again, two of the same sprues. This is slide molded, so this is nice. And some nice texture there, detail. Wonder if it's, yeah, it's actually open, as you can see. Oh, that's nice as well. And again, two of them. So more small screws and get them out of the way first. That's a wheel. These look like bay doors. Don't know if they're weapon bay or landing bay. They're bay doors, that's for sure. I'm guessing this will be the front. No, this is too long. This will be one of the sides. And this is, I'm guessing, just the wheelway. Looks good, see no defects, a lot of small surface details. Let's give you a close up. In there, the aluminium structure, I think it's aluminium or aluminum, depending on where you're from. And there's the wheel. And you can see, oh, I can't see now because I dropped it. It's a there's almost no thread on it. You got the doors for open and for closed, and I'm guessing that this is the wheel bay. This is a single one, so I would say this is the front still. Yeah, I'm guessing. Well, never know. Big sprues time. This is something with a lot of curved stuff. This is some damn fine molding. Really wavy. That's done nicely. Turbine. Thingies. These are, if I wouldn't be no bad, I would almost think that these are underwing weapon placement pods, what you call them. Yeah, where you put your bombs on. Weapon pods, something else. I think these are for under the wing. 1, 2, 3, 4, each wing 2. Pylons, weapon pylons. I think, I don't know what this is just blank. And this is very wavy, so this could be anything. Oh, I think this is the intake manifold, where this thing goes into. Guess, well, what's this for then? There's nothing, anything as wavy as this in the entire plane. So that's kind of strange. But a lot of surface detail on this. This looks very good. I'll give you a close up. Well, this is very big and wavy, this, and smooth. Got some small parts here. These are the interesting parts of this sprue. I think these are pylons, for underwing pylons, for the drop tanks and smart bombs and all that stuff. And here's the turbine fan. Here's some small stuff again, and here more wavy big stuff. I really wonder what's so wavy in this plane. Next up, I see the exhaust funnel. I think it's called an exhaust. Something that's clearly too big for the back. Oh, this is the intake thing. There's, well, like I thought, is the there's a turbine blade on the inside. This is the, well, let's keep it, call it an exhaust for the plane. Looks very nice. These are something that's really wired up. And all kinds of small stuffs. This is the thing that goes on the top. It might just be a fuel port for mid-flight fueling. Looks like an antenna, but it's probably something else. Would be funny seeing this thing sticking on top of it. I have no clue what this is. I think it's the sides, but maybe cockpit sides. But then again, what is this? Can be both. Here's some lines, probably for the wheelbase, and then the intake. Let's show, see if I can show it to this one to you first. Need to catch the light on the right angle. That's quite hard. There it is. See, there's the intake manifold. And the rest I'm going to show you like this, the normal way. These are some lighting lines, either electrical or there's the exhaust nozzle. I think it's called a nozzle these days. This thing that goes on the top. Small stuff, and here the, I'm going to say bulkheads, but bulkheads are for ships. So I don't think that goes for planes as well. Some small stuff here. Can see. Don't know what that is. Looks interesting and important, but that's that. Well, not knowing what stuff is makes it kind of hard to explain, because you don't know what you're explaining into, but also build, because you don't know what it is you're putting in where, so you don't know if it's correct. Wheels, yeah, this is the landing bay gear, so the single one was the nose gear. These are parts for the landing bay, landing gear bays, doors, wheels, the studs, or the arms, or the legs, whatever you call it. And some hydraulic pistons. I think they go on here. This probably so for the wheelbase. Two-part wheels. The nose gear was only a single part, just a wheel. The all the surface detail there. And I've heard a couple of people buy these from metal, so to say. What I noticed now, you don't see it here. Maybe I can show it like this. Those are bent inwards slightly. And it doesn't look like that's an accident, so they are supposed to be like that. Sorry. And these things. And then the wheels, two parts. Kind of strange shape there as well. And then the bay doors. You got these two, those get interesting if you turn it around. Oh, you can see the plumbing is there, but you can also see some check the pin marks in there, which might need removal. I don't know how much you can see from once it's all put together. What we do have here? Now this I know. This is a pilot seat, ejector seat, with the sides of the ejector seats. This is part of the displays. This is the cockpit. This is the cockpit top. This is where you pit your cock. These will probably be landing bay doors. Headrest. Small thingies. This is for the HUD. Heads up display. Goes in there. Joysticks. The grapple to activate your ejector seat, it goes overhead. At least it does in the movies. Pedals, apparently looks like it. But this is the HUD then. No, this won't be the HUD. No, it's the HUD that goes in there. Does that go in there? No, that's going there. Oh, this is the where the cockpit glass goes. This one, I showed it in a minute. Actually, I'm going to put it right now. The clear parts. Extra layer of protection over it, so that's nice. It's a bit sticky. It doesn't come off that easily. This is very clear. I need something you can read. Oh, well, this is good enough. No, I'm not making, I'm not being sponsored by them, but it's just to show. Put it up to the camera. It's a clear part. Let's focus on down there. There it is. A little bit of warpage in the glass. But not a lot there, see? But not a lot, it's very clear, it's very shiny. I wanted to see, because I think this should go there. Does it go over it? Like that? Nah. Should go there like this, but that doesn't fit for... Huh? Like this? Glass on the outside? Well, that fits. But it doesn't make sense. Otherwise, it doesn't fit at all. So now you know how much I know of planes. Ping. You have friends. No, they just act like it. Oh, fuck. Yeah. How smart was it to get the protected layer of it? Not so smart. You're an idiot. Never told anyone otherwise. Put this back so you've seen the clear parts as well. And that I have no clue how something should fit. Give you a close up of this one. Can all the, that's the headrest, hooks and stuff and cranks, and there's a bay door, yeah, more bay doors, all the nice and rounded curvy forms in it. That's nice. This is the part of the cockpit, part of the HUD, sides of the ejector seat, the seat itself, HUD, turn it around so you can see the cockpit top, yeah, some details there over there as you can see, and that's it for this one, and then we got two more screws to go, and these will be boring screws, they're wings, but nevertheless they're quite important on a plane. And there's all kinds of strange forms on this one. Nothing on the inside, just the outside. It's gonna be the Queen of Diamonds. You can see that the riveted edge. Very fine, and again here's the same. And then you got the parts here on the end. And then the flaps and Jellicoe's ailerons. And then you got them on the front and on the rear. They're not both flaps, are they? And the last sprue. And for some reason this one is heat shield, compared to all the other used the old Tamiya way. And these are the horizontal and vertical stabilizers. That I don't know. Again, very clean mold. All the, there's more rounded stuff on this plane than I thought. There's some rivets again on the base. And no detail on the inside. Bing, I think somebody just spoke up. And then last but not least. Yeah, sorry, give me 2 seconds. I'm gonna turn off the sound, otherwise we're gonna get nuts. Because a certain Canadian just woke up and he's gonna talk. He probably knew I was doing this, so this is his revenge. So you got the photo edge, that is all the photo edge, which is fine with me. Did I cut? cut this off too carefully. Yeah. This is all the photo edge. So there is a fan blade, a no clue what, and a seal belt for the pilot. And for some reason that small thing has a dot in the middle. Maybe it could, does that cover? No. So that's all the photo edge, which is a fine thing, like I said. And now, one of the most important things on this one, I guess, the actual photo edge. It says made in China, so they're not cartographed. They're actually not shiny at all, they're a sound of a satin finish. As you can see, there's the 70 years. And this is Diana, Goddess of Huntress. And there you see 323, that's the flying squadron that uses these. The first squadron in the Netherlands with them. The Dutch Roundels. And then there are the, how you call them, stencils. All kinds of fun stuff. Well, to be honest, this is only small. I've seen planes that have this size of a decal sheet, so I'm not complaining too much. This will be an interesting plane to build. This is just this, well, the color colors call for almost a black, but the one I've seen, and I've stood about 5 meters away from it, and wasn't black, it was lightest dark, yeah, a very strange gray, not too dark even. But yeah, this finishes, put the backs on so you can see the beauty, my review of the Meng Lockheed Martin F-35A Lightning II fighter, the Royal Netherlands Air Force, flown by through 323 Squadron under the guidance of Diana the Huntress, and their 70-year-old anniversary tail art, which looks to be a very nicely molded kit. I only did, of course, the test fitting of the upper and lower fuselage, and without even cleaning anything up, it closed almost completely. I will have to check out how I have to do the glass for the cockpit, because I have no clue as well. That's not a surprise. But this will be an interesting build. There's way more curviness to the plane than I thought. You can see it here as well. It's just... So that's a nice surprise. And all in all, it's... yeah, it's gonna be interesting, to say the least. It's a very beautiful kit. The molding's brilliantly done. No, I haven't seen any mistakes or misfires or short shots or flash or whatever. It's just very beautiful molded and designed kit. And my experience so far with other Meng kits is that it will go together quite easily and without any problems. Now to find the courage to build it. But well, if you like my review of this, please like, subscribe, join. Hit the bell if you want to know when I'm uploading my next. And then I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.